सर्वभूतेषु ज्ञान रूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो नमः। I admire and praise and try to connect to the wisdom present in the universe and present in all of us and start our discussions on Vedas, on Vedas fire rituals. Yesterday we discussed about the language of Vedas. We call it Vedic language. There was no name at the time. Later, all the Vedic rituals, all the Vedic mantras got written in Sanskrit, because Sanskrit was the ancient language. Now we can assess still today. And depending upon how they got translated from Sanskrit to Hindi and from Hindi to English, meaning kept changing. Few things what we talked about was cow, mother, and horse, ashwa. Actually, these words what we are using in English are not the real translation of those Vedic words. Now, next word what I want to take is Agni. Agni, for Agni, even in Sanskrit, we have many words. Many words for Agni are in Sanskrit. In other way, I should have said, there are several words for fire in Sanskrit. Sometimes we call anal, sometimes we call davanal, sometimes we call aag, pavak, and we also call agni. So what is the difference? Why we have so many words? What was the need of so many words? Because pavak is of different types. A fire which burns our forest down is different than the fire we put in our fire pots for our offerings, for our havi to reach to the universal energies, different kind of universal energies. And what these universal energies are known as? Devata. They are known in Sanskrit, Deva. Deva, when we first translated into English, we called them God. And then we realized maybe we have made a mistake, and then another translation became in the form of deity. But whatever name you take in English, the meaning of Deva is De. Vah. Vah is anyone. De, give. Any energy, any entity, any shape, any form, any human, any word, anything. Anything what can give us without expecting anything back from us. Capacity to give without expecting back is called Deva. Or Devi, if it is feminine, then Devi, and if it is masculine, it is called Deva. Anything which has got capacity to give, and from that giving, our life can become continuous. So what are they? There was chit jal pavak gagan samira. Earth is Dev because it keeps giving us something to eat. If there is no earth, there would be no banana. So earth keeps giving us for us something to eat. Therefore, earth is a god, a goddess. Jal, the water. Water, without water we cannot live. And anyone who gives water, like rain gives us water, they don't expect anything back from us. And therefore, we call it Varuna Deva. Varuna Deva is water element and is considered to be a god. Third, Agni, the fire elements. It cooks your food without expecting anything back from you. These days, you are paying the electricity bill to create fire. But that fire is not charging that money. That money our corporations are charging, our gas companies are charging. Gas is free. It is present in the earth. But you have to work to take it out, purify it for your use. And this money is being charged for taking it out, purifying, and whatever it is. But otherwise, fire is available to us. It cooks our food. It provides energy without expecting anything back from us. And that is why this is also considered God, deity, whatever. Next, air. Air, if it is not available, not present here, we will not be able to breathe. And because of that, it is being considered as deity. And space is also considered as deity. And then the planets which made it possible, sun is considered God. Moon, because of what water element we have on earth, is also considered a godly energy. So this is what Vedic language is. And according to Vedic languages, if you understand things, you will be able to understand the manifestation ritual. You will be able to understand the ceremonies. You will be able to understand everything what is written in Vedas. As and when we will be passing through some of the names, some of the words, and there be needed an explanation, we will try and explain them. Now, going ahead, rishis are one who has given us wisdom. So, rishis, wherever we say that so-and-so rishis, the whole wisdom of Vedas has come through rishis. Not only seven of them. Sapt rishis, of course, they were very important, but their children, their grandchildren, and their everyone has contributed to bring this wisdom to us, and anyone who has contributed to bring this wisdom to us was called rishi. Now, we go a step further and we'll start the first thing with Sam Veda. How many Vedas are there? Four, yeah. Which one of them? Sam Ved, Yajur Ved, Athar Ved, and Rig Ved. And out of these, Krishna in Gita has said, that the most important among all these is Samveda. And therefore, we will try to discuss about the Samveda first. Okay. Now, let us understand what is the meaning of Samis. Why the name Samveda? Why not some other name? Name matters. There is a tendency these days that we want to change name of everything. Anything you say, you want to change the name. But the moment we change the name, something gets changed too. It doesn't remain the same original thing. And therefore, name is very important. Samved, the name is also important. Sa means rucha. Am means alapa. Alapa is a sound. Rucha is a poem. A Veda, then it says Veda. A Ved which can be written in rucha, written in poetry, and can be sung. So, few days back, some of you were asking, can I sing mantras? And I said, no, mantras, the meaning of mantra is manan plus tra. That means, anything what you do inside of yourself, repeat again and again for providing protection to yourself was called mantra. Therefore, every stanza, every poetry, every poem which is in Samved can be sung. And therefore, we call it Rusha. We don't call it, because even if you want to call it mantra, we call it Samved mantra. You can sing them. Mantras which you can sing are Samveda. So association of Richa and Alap is Sam. And therefore, Samveda is that part of Veda which normally you can sing. Even when rituals are being performed, if you have seen, ceremonies are being performed, those priests, they try to sing it. Okay. And when you can sing, then it becomes Samveda. Another association is that, as I have said to you about Richa and Alap, Sa also means woman. Sa. I think we are doing these days Sanskrit lessons. And there, when I was talking about pronouns, we have spoken about these pronouns, Sa and Sa. Sa is Stri, Sa is feminine, and Am is masculine. So, Sam also means association of feminine and masculine. A Veda, a wisdom which discusses about the association of feminine and masculine in the universe is called Samveda. Sa is earth, Alap is Dev, and therefore association of earth with Devas. What are those Devas? Water, air, fire, space, okay, sun energy, moon energy, and all that. association of the energy of earth with the energy of sun and other planets is also Sam. Sam Ved can be understood in these three different manners, in three different discussions. So, we will, from next session onwards, start discussing about different recharge of Sam Vedas. Today, what you carry with you is, what is the meaning of Sam Veda? What is the meaning of Agni? What is the meaning of Havi? What is the meaning of Dev? What is the meaning of Devi? And what is Rishi? If you have understood this much, it will be easier for us to start with the first chapter of Sam Veda tomorrow. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.